Hey, what is up, everybody? This is Steve DeBreach coming to you here today as we're looking over WWE's Money in the Bank men's match. This is probably eight of the top competitors in WWE. They really sort of loaded this match down. Although when you really look at the grand scheme of things, some of the guys in here are sort of middle of the pack guys. But I think honestly when it comes down to it, a lot of these people are fan favorites that are looking to break out of the mid card. I think this is really going to make this be a really, really fun match. You've got Andrade CM Almas, you've got Ricochet, Drew McIntyre, Finn Balor, Braun Strowman, everybody's favorite, Baron Corbin. We've got Ali, and then we've also got Randy Orton. Randy Orton is going to be coming into this match with veteran spirit. He's done a lot of these sort of Money in the Bank matches where he's just sort of fit himself into the card. Randy's in a weird spot in his career. I know there was those rumors running around that his contract was going to end and he was looking to go to AEW. I don't really see how Randy Orton was going to be a fit for AEW at all. But when I look at this, I don't really know where Randy Orton fits into WWE. I know that Orton's going to be wanting to work as much as possible to make as much money as possible, but I think that WWE needs to be looking to, wind down Randy Orton. I'm not saying retire him and put him out the pasture, but there's a reason why when guys, get up there in the card and they've been in WWE for a long time, they sort of become, those part-timers. And I think Orton, the last time I was really excited to see him would be that main event match at SummerSlam against Brock Lesnar, where he ended up just getting demolished. But I think that would be really, really fun to see him get built up again, even if he's not one of my favorite guys. Easily, Randy Orton winning the Money in the Bank briefcase would be something to sort of, jumpstart that career again. I really honestly just don't see it happening. He's sort of just like an enhancement. That's really low because I didn't really think what I was saying. He's not a jobber. He's not putting guys over. I think he's there to help the card. He is a fan favorite even when he is a heel. A lot of people like him. I just don't happen to be him. But I think that even the biggest Randy Orton fans, take notice that he hasn't really been in a big match since the match at WrestleMania 33 against Bray Wyatt for the WWE Championship. And that run was over, really, honestly, before it even started. So Bray didn't do a good job with the belt. Randy didn't do a good job with the belt. And it is what it is. Ali is a guy that I think that it's fun to see somebody get called up from 205 Live and sort of get that push where it makes them look like they're actually going to be something on the SmackDown roster. It'd be fun to see him in here, but I think he has no shot. Baron Corbin is a guy that I understand, there's heels in the business that you're supposed to hate, and it is what it is, but Baron Corbin's honestly probably somebody that I'm never going to care about in the wrestling business. Honestly, one of the nicest guys that I've ever met. When I met him at the Aftershock rock concert deal here in Sacramento a few years ago, when he was in NXT, there's nothing really hard against it. It's just the character that they've painted him into, where he was that sort of lone wolf, and now all of a sudden he's this sort of corporate guy coming down in his nice dress shirt and his vest. He's not the GM anymore. He's not working for Vince. He's not working for Shane. The gimmick is over, but yet he's still wearing the crap. Doesn't really make sense to me. When Val Venis turned into Sean Morley and the whole Sean Morley deal ended, he went back to being Val Venis when he wasn't working for Bischoff anymore. So I'm not really sure what they're doing, but there's no way in the world that he's going to win this match. Braun Strowman, how long have we been looking for this guy to get the push? Last year, they went over, they did Crown Jewel in Saudi Arabia. He had the match against Brock Lesnar for the vacant Universal Championship. I think everybody in the world was picking Braun to get the win. Braun didn't win. Brock got the championship, and Braun was nowhere to be seen for the rest of the year. It was my Royal Rumble pick. It made the most sense for Braun to win that Rumble, but they ended up going with Rollins, who was a favorite in my eyes like a couple months beforehand. But once they took Braun out of the Rumble and made it so obvious that Braun was going to get added back in, it only made sense to me that Strowman was getting added back to the Rumble so he would win it. Finn Balor, your Intercontinental Champion. I've been banging this drum for a while that he is one of the most important guys in wrestling. He's one of the most fan favorite guys that has a huge group of fans. I'm hoping that maybe even the heel turn is coming sooner than later for Finn, because of the fact that so many people love him, but yet they won't put the push to him. And to me, honestly, in my mind, him winning the Intercontinental Championship once was all right, but him losing it and then regaining it sort of shows that he's being pigeonholed in that mid-card slot, and that's not really what I thought he was going to be when he came over from New Japan and was moving up through NXT as one of the, you know, hottest competitors that WWE was pushing. Is this is the future of the business, and I don't know why they don't see it in him. You know, for one reason or not, he won the Universal Championship, he had the injury, he rehabbed, he came back, and they've never really pushed him to that spot other than letting him have the match at the Rumble against Brock Lesnar. McIntyre, in my eyes, I thought was going to be the next main eventer. I'm really surprised that he's not main eventing against the Universal Champion here on the show. But then again, he lost to Roman Reigns at WrestleMania. So that one, honestly, makes no sense to me. Ricochet is easily probably a favorite to win this match. He is new to the roster. He is somebody that WWE is looking to push right out of the gate, a lot like they did for Finn Balor. So it'd be fun to see him get the win here. Andrade Cien Almas is my pick to win this match. So I'm hoping, you know, him getting moved from SmackDown to Raw back to SmackDown, in my eyes, is not a good look. I'm really hoping that somebody on the SmackDown brand really put their foot down, that they were losing somebody that was going to be a bright future for SmackDown. But I'm not really 100% sure that even WWE knows what they're doing with this guy. And when he got moved during the Superstar Shakeup last year, he was my pick to be main eventing in WWE by SummerSlam. And that didn't happen, but I'm really hoping that, you know, here we are a year in, and he's been in some big matches. He hasn't won those matches, but he's always been putting in good matches. I'm hoping that that's going to get recognized. Him winning the Money in the Bank is a real big way for him to turn it around. So I'm picking Andrade Cien Almas, but in the back of my mind, McIntyre getting the win, I think, would not be a surprise. I think he would be the odds-on favorite to win this. Braun Strowman is somebody who really needs it. Finn is somebody that I think the fans are going to be voting for. And, you know, Baron Corbin and Ali, I don't think there's any chance in hell those guys are winning this match.